Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Teri. If you're new here, I really appreciate you stopping by. In this week's video, I'm going to be customizing my MacBook Pro. It's kind of a continuation or a part two of last week's video where I customized my iPhone and my iPad. So just another Apple device customization for this week. I've really been procrastinating organizing and customizing these devices, so I'm really excited to finally get to my laptop. So I thought I'd take you along and share with you how to change your folder icons, as well as design a beautiful wallpaper in Canva. I'm also gonna show you some tips and tricks on how to personalize some other applications like Safari and Google Chrome, and make everything super aesthetic and fall vibes. With that being said, let's get started with this MacBook Pro customization. This is my desktop at the moment. I had a bunch of files that were kind of cluttered on the desktop. So the first thing you want to do if you're following along is organize everything into folders like I have here. This is a little spoiler. You can see this is probably what I'm going to customize all the other folders to look like, but they will look like these at the beginning. So I put everything into folders and I just named them a general name. I kind of want to actually have some Christmas ideas for gifts and ways to decorate and things like that. So I'm just editing the name so they're all lowercase and consistent. All right, perfect. So now everything's consistently named with lowercase lettering. I'm going to jump into Canva and I'm going to make a background to replace this floral one. So what you're gonna wanna do, you're gonna go to the top search bar and type in desktop wallpaper, and it will give you some options, templates and such to use as inspiration, or you can use them exactly like they're provided. So you see you got a lot of options. Some options are not free and some are, depending on if you have Canva Pro or not. The one that I picked actually does have an element in it that is something that's paid, but I ended up changing it so it'll work out that I can use it. So this is the one that I did, but let me just pull it up here. So I've just opened up the original template that was provided, and here it is. It's got boxes where you can organize, I guess, to-do lists and things, to have separate stickies that have different priority levels, which is something I didn't really need to do. So I did customize it quite a bit, and I can show you, this is the end result. But there are a few things I do need to change that will give me the chance to show you how I did it. So as you can see, the boxes are in a different formation, and that's super easy to do. So all you'll need to do is, first off, because I don't need this needs attention, I ended up using this box as personal files. So I just changed the names and then moved things around. But before I moved things around, I ended up selecting both boxes by clicking, holding shift and clicking personal files and grouping the elements together so they can move at the same time. So again, I just selected the box, held the shift key, clicked on the text box and grouped them. Perfect. Once all of those are grouped, I can move them around. So I believe I put, I put this box at the top left here, this box over here, this box over here, and I just will then move those as well. All right, just to keep things simple, I'm just gonna delete this frame here, put that there. I'm gonna delete this one as well, just to have a simple kind of different design to show you what I did. Just edit this box so it is a little bit bigger. You can just hold on the bottom corner to drag and make that bigger, and then you can make it a bit skinnier by using this little doodad here. All right, once I have them so they're along the same lines here, perfect, that's good enough for now for what we're doing. I'm going to add another frame here. So these are frames where you can insert an image of your choosing. So if you go to elements, you'll want to search frame, and this signifies that you can put something else within it. Unfortunately, unlike these elements where you can adjust the size on the side, these ones don't give you those options. So I need to find something that's more or less going to be perfect for what I want to do. So I'm going to see if this works. It's got those rounded edges. All I need to do is make it a little smaller, which you can do. That's fine. All right, that kind of works. And to make it work, I'm going to take that and duplicate it. So all I need to do, I'm very much with the key commands. I'm obsessed with them. So to duplicate this, I hold down the Option key and drag, and it just gives me another element that I can use. Perfect. So obviously I'm gonna keep it the way it is, the way I finalized this one, but I'm just kind of doing this to show you how I did it. So to add the image to your frame, you go to uploads, and I have a bunch of different images from other projects. I'm going to take, let's say, this one and put it in. All you have to do is click and drag into that element. Just to show you how to upload photos into Canva, I'd used a lot of Pinterest photos. So I do have a board, which I'll link down below. And to use an image, all you gotta do is pick the image that you want. So just trying to decide here. Okay, let's do this one. You can either click and drag the image onto your desktop or go to these three dots here and click download image. All right, once that's downloaded, go back to Canva and then just drag and drop it into your upload section. And then it'll just take a few moments to download that image. But once it's complete, all you gotta do is the same way, just drag and drop in the element. And so as you can see, this is the paid portion. It's got a watermark, and in order to ensure that you don't have to pay for your final design, all you have to do is replace the image in the frame. And to adjust where it's showing up, you can just double click and drag. You can even make it bigger to choose kind of what portion of the image is displayed within the frame. Once you're done, you can click out of it, or there was a done button up there that you could click. So that's basically it. I'm just gonna keep it for now, but I'm going to go to my final page. And I just realized that I made this a few weeks ago, and at that point it would have been fine to have the September calendar for a little longer, but now I've got to change that. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to see if I can find an October calendar within templates. Instead of rearranging all the numbers and doing it that way, it might take a little bit longer to get that done. So I've made a new page by just adding page, and then I'm going to search here, the best of my ability, October 2021 calendar. I'm gonna see what comes up. So I found this one that does have the correct configuration for the dates. So I'm gonna show you how to take this and put it over here. All right, so since this is already grouped together, I just need to select everything and quickly ungroup it. I will want to keep this September 2021 text box. I'm just going to say October 2021, and I'm just going to move it out of the way for a second, put it over here, as well as move the box out of the way for a second. Once that's done, I'm just going to click and drag to select all those numbers that are the same color as the background, so they're kind of hidden, and I'm just going to click delete so that they're all gone. And then going back to this design, I'm gonna do a similar thing. Just take all of these elements here and just delete them so that they're out of the way. Okay, all I have to do is click and drag so that everything is selected here and bring it over to my design. Now I wanna make sure that everything is kind of cohesive, so that font needs to be changed as well as the color. So I'm gonna change the color first here. I'm gonna ungroup and select them again. That is the color, I believe, of everything. It's gonna blend in with the background for a few moments until I get my box back in here. So I'm gonna go to the font and change it. The font that I used is Catchy Major, and it's already up here because it is already in my design. It's not exactly the same. All right, I'm just gonna select them again and then group and put the box back here. Awesome. And because it's a group, it's just so much easier to move it all together instead of moving each individual box and then aligning it. It's so much work. And then add that October box right back in there. I feel like this needs to be just a little smaller maybe. The last thing I wanna do is I kinda think that everything here is just a bit too big. So I'm just going to click and drag and then just make everything just a tad smaller and fit it perfectly in my box, just a bit smaller. Perfect. Now that I'm done with that, all I have to do is click download up here, select the page that I do want to download, and there you go, download it. So to change my background, I just go to System Preferences, click Desktop and Screensaver, and what I'm gonna do is I'm going to take the downloaded file and just put it in my desktop backgrounds folder, and then it's right there for me to use. All right, now that we have the background the way we want it, I'm gonna go in, swipe three fingers up, and ensure that these desktops are deleted if you have any extras, and then add new ones so that your background is consistent within all your desktops. You can also change your desktop to be completely different. All you have to do is go to that other desktop, again, go to System Preferences, Desktop and Screensaver, and then change it to another image. The only thing you'll want to kind of be wary about is the fact that all your files will be in a weird kind of position on your screen, and you might not want that to happen, so I'm going to keep it just to be the same. So now is where we're going to change the folder icons and make them these circles. So first thing I'm gonna do here is I'm just gonna move those out of the way. Put them in this spot. So I kind of wanted to see, I hadn't done this yet, to see what it would look like with these circles. I'm not sure if I like that now. All right, I think I'm gonna do kind of rounded squares instead so I can show you how to change that. So let's go to Canva, and I'm just going to choose an Instagram post is going to be the dimensions of this, basically just a square. So this is the one that I had, and because I don't pay for Canva Pro, it does come with this white background, which I won't want. But let's just change this so it's not a circle. I'm gonna go to Elements, and then I'm gonna look for Shapes. And you can use anything. You can use a little graphic that's a fall graphic or something like that if you want. I'm just choosing this so that it's a little bit more simple. All right, so I'm just going to delete the circle and then put this here so it is pretty big in the square. I'm also gonna change the color by going up here and picking that color that I had before. That's done. I'm going to just download it. If you do pay for the subscription, you can download with a transparent background, but I'm gonna show you basically how to do that easily with Preview. So this is the final design that opens up automatically in Preview. You see that white background. All you have to do is click this little icon here, the circle with the pen. It's the markup toolbar comes up, and you're gonna click this magic wand icon. Use your mouse and just click until there's a plus and drag until all of your white is gone. You don't wanna go too far because otherwise it will delete your image that you want. So you go as far as all the white is selected. When you release, it will kind of have this dotted line, and then all you have to do is click delete. There it is. It's got a transparent background that you can use. Now to change your actual folder, I'm going to just click Command A, or you can just click and drag so that it's selected, and click copy. So Command C is the key command. Just right click the folder that you want to change and click get info. All you want to do is select the folder till it's selected and paste. That way the image will be what you had designed. So perfect. And if I didn't mention, the key command is command V to paste. And the one thing I hated when they updated, I think it was to Big Sur, I don't remember the update specifically, but you used to be able to select all your folders, right click, and click cleanup selection, but that no longer exists in the drop-down menu. You can go to your top bar and click view and then click cleanup selection. So everything kind of gets put in a cleaner format. Of course, it doesn't recognize that you want it to be like that. So you can almost get it to be nicely cleaned up. Even by trying again, there you go, perfect. So I just need to move those until they're the way I want them. And then I can just move the hard drive. You can change your hard drive to be a different image by doing the same thing, but I don't want to, just because I don't want to accidentally do something weird and delete it or anything like that. I want to know that that's the hard drive. Like I said, you can change your hard drive. You can also change your applications. If you go to your applications, click open in Finder, it's the same process. Right click and click get info on any of the apps and paste your design. I don't want to change them because they're really out of the way, so I don't need to worry about it being, you know, not with the theme because I've hidden my dock. Oh, what I didn't do is I didn't add a sticky. So all you have to do is open Stickies and drag it into the desktop that you want to use. And you can change the color based on your aesthetic. I made it gray, and I also went to window and I made it a little bit more translucent. But let's change the font. So if you go up to the top menu, click font, show fonts, you have all the fonts to choose from. Kind of like this one, actually. And then I'm going to change the size to make it a bit smaller. So, all right, so that's basically my desktop customization. The last two things that I want to do is just change the way my Safari looks when I first open it. I have this image that comes up. It's a bunch of pretty clouds, but I want to change it so it's a little bit more fall. So I haven't selected an image yet, so I'm just going to quickly go to Pinterest. All right, I'm going to see if this one works. I ended up finding a different thing from this person's website. I'm actually gonna save the pin here. It's called hercreativesstudio.com. And there was a free download for this desktop. I really liked it better than what I just did. I'm gonna end up using it. So I click download now. It opens another tab with the image. So I'm gonna grab it, click and drag and put it in my downloads. See, this is what I selected, but I think it's just too busy. It's just too much for my liking. So I'm gonna click that icon, click X, and click plus, and then find that image that I put in my downloads. And that's what it looks like after the fact. I prefer this to the other one. The white pumpkins are super simple and pretty. I'm gonna click out of Safari. If you don't use Safari, if you use Google Chrome as your main web browser, you can also edit the way your Chrome looks. So all you have to do, I already have the menu open, is you click on the three dots and then you go to settings. I'm already in settings. You'll want to click appearance over here. You can click theme, which will bring up the Chrome web store. So there's either extensions or themes that you can choose made by Google or elsewhere. I ended up scrolling through finding one called Amber Autumn, which look at that. So beautiful. So I'm gonna click add to Chrome. So now when I open up Google Chrome, I have this beautiful fall road.
All right, that's basically it. That's how I customized my MacBook Pro today. If you do have any questions about any of the steps or how I did the customization, please leave your comment down below and I'll definitely get to it. If you did like the way I customized my MacBook, I will leave my Pinterest board link down below with the wallpaper that I did end up making, as well as, you know, my boards with cute fall wallpapers and things, so you can take some inspiration from my creation or you can make a brand new design of your own. All of that will be in the description below, so you can check that out. Either way, if you did like this video, I would really appreciate if you gave it a like and also subscribe and turn on your notification bell so you know exactly when I post each week. Thanks so much for watching and I'll see you next week.